I don't like your little games. Don't like your tilted stage. The role you made me play of the fool. No, I don't like you. I don't like your perfect crime. How you laugh when you lie. You said the gun was mine. Is it cool? No, I don't like you.
Quitter and a loser, like everybody said.
No, I didn't
even make it out of your yard, Russ. No, you know how bad that irks me. I'm the first actor from Parks Mortis to come up here, and I was just...
It's okay, man. Look at me. It's okay. You did good. You tried. Mom, I need you to come pick him up, okay? It's show's over. And, but don't feel bad about it. Seriously, don't feel bad about it. This is not for everybody. It's not. Keep that camera on.
I knew my temper would be the one thing. Yeah. The one thing. I shouldn't even told my brother to...
But let me tell you something. I can't tell you something. A little inside ballpark. Nobody was ragging on you. Your mom wasn't saying anything bad.
No, that's not your what bothered me.
I know, but I was just lying to you. Nobody was... Nobody was calling you a loser. Nobody was saying anything. That was just me getting inside your head. And you were super easy for me to get inside your head on.
You know what's funny? You were in there, but it didn't bother me. It didn't bother me that you were telling, hey, your mom thinks you're a loser. I know. Okay, cool. Let's see her come do it. You know, come on.
But I just want you to know she wasn't. She wasn't saying any of that. I was lying to you about everything.
And that's what you're here to
do. That's what I'm here to do, right?
That is what you're here to do. But then again, it just...
I know.
Why do I have to do this? This isn't the first time I've done this to myself either. I've done this to myself in real life situations. I'm going to go do this. And then I get inside my own damn head and I break myself.
It can happen. I mean, especially here at the Manor. The Manor is a very... You know, psychologically, very fascinating to watch people come through here. And it's not easy, though. I mean, you're a strong guy. You're a tough guy.
Yeah, but my problem is I didn't make it out of your yard.
That's okay. A lot of people don't. You can't feel bad about it. But I will leave an open invite to you to come back and do it again. Okay? I will leave that invite to you to come back and try again. It's not like I said, you didn't get any worse, so we're not going to give any secrets away or anything, right? So we're going to start you over again. We can do that. But all the naysayers out there, you need to understand it's more difficult than you think. Everybody has different breaking points. Everybody has different limitations. So don't judge until you come here yourself.
Are you live?
I am live right now.
To everybody that's been talking crap.
But they haven't been talking crap, though.
Well, no, to everybody that talked crap all week long. Oh, he ain't going to... I guess, Brandon, I guess you're right. I didn't even make it through the waiver. But you know why I didn't make it through the waiver? Because this man right here, Russ Mckamey, he's smart. He's not going to let my unstable butt in his haunted house. Because that could hurt him. Phoenix could get hurt. I could get hurt. You know, last thing he needs is his neighbor over there. Is watching.
Yeah, they're watching, aren't they?
Waiting for anything for him to slip up.
Yep.
I mean, I guess there was a reason they kicked you out of California. Because I guess people there, they couldn't handle it.
They ran me out of town.
They ran you out of town. And I hate to see somebody that loves the industry as much as I do. Now, you've been in it since you were a kid.
Yeah.
I've only been at ARCS for 4 years, and I love it. I love the Haunted House history, and I hate to see when people like you or, you know, Phoenix, I hate it when it's everybody gets hurt, you know. You know, you can't do what you love because there's people out there that hate what you do. And that kills me. My own family, my mom's side of... Her mom, her brothers, they don't like what I do.
This is great. It's entertainment, man. It's theater.
They don't like it. They don't understand that. I believe it was either Thanksgiving or Christmas. I went over there, and one of the family members over there, they do like what I do. So I brought in, you know, a top hat that I had for my character and his mask. I walked in, and they immediately went, take that back outside. That's we don't want that here. I had my uncle dogging me, dogging what I do. He said, well, what do you do? I said, well, my hobby is Oryx Mortis. He goes, well, if you're pouring money into it, it ain't a hobby. It's just a money pit. You don't understand. That's what I love to do. I don't get out much. I live in a hole in West Point. I don't get out much. I play video games, eat a bunch of food, and hey, do Oryx Mortis.
What's your favorite game, man? I'm a gamer, too.
RPGs, just first-person shooters.
I love first-person shooters. I'm a gamer, man. And, about to play sometime.
Yeah, for real. Yeah. And without all this mental bullcrap.
Absolutely, man.
You are smart. You are a smart man, Russ, and you were right to call it right now, because I'm not stable.
You're all right, man. Just understand that everything I told you was a lie.
Oh, I know that.
You understand it, right?
I wasn't lying to you when I talked to you on the phone the night my brother messaged you. I had done research about the Mckamey matter since 2014, since Tristan Pierce said, hey, man, there's a crazy haunted house out there. There's a crazy haunted house out in California that they touch you, they rough you up, they mentally get inside your head. I was behind you 150% before I even knew anything about it. Then I did the research, and then I went, yeah, that's crazy. I wasn't what you call an LIC.
Right.
I knew what I was getting into, but then again, it still pisses me off that I broke myself.
Yeah,
I trash talked this boy so hard, it's not even funny. I wanted him to break me. I ended up breaking myself.
That's pretty typical, though. Everybody breaks themselves, right? That's kind of how it rolls. But you, as a haunter, understand why I had to pull the plug,
yes,
right?
Yes, I completely understand. Oryx Mortis is what y'all here at Mckamey would consider a boo haunt. We can't touch you. The worst thing we can do is get in your face.
Right.
And we're not even allowed to do that. Well, it's not that we're not allowed. We can do it, but it's strongly advised that we don't get in somebody's face. We get in somebody's face, you get punched.
Yep.
And when you get punched, nobody has fun. Nobody enjoys it.
No.
But Vinny, he runs a safe haunt, and so do you. I completely...
Safety has to come first, right?
Oh,
safety,
yes,
is paramount. And
yes.
Even though all the haters out there think that we're not safe, we're actually very safe. And I have to be that way because the kind of things that you would be doing out there would really be difficult, you know? But, and you know, it'd be the biggest challenge you've ever had at a haunt, for sure. But, again, you're welcome to come back and try again when you think that you're ready to do it. So I know you said you wouldn't want to try again, but I'd say try again.
I mean, I want to, but I have a feeling that it's going to end up the same way. I'm going to get to page 12. Everybody see this right here? Page 12. I was right here reading. What this? I just got up here. It is what time, Phoenix?
4:42.
It is 4:42. I have been here for 2 hours. Well, it's all over. I'm going home. Right here. I got right here. I said, this man didn't do it. He didn't do it. He poured blood on me. Fake blood. Then I had an outburst. And then Russ took $500 from me. Then I said, screw it. Here's your money, Russ. I don't want your money. The money was nice. I really liked the $20,000 gesture. But I didn't come here for the money. I came here to see if I could do it. And guess what? I can't.
This time.
I let myself down.
No, man. Listen, seriously, it's all a game. This is all a game.
It's all a game, but...
Do not beat yourself up about it.
I don't like losing.
Yeah. Well, we all lose, man. Lose life, right? This is how you handle the loss, right? We all lose. It's just about how we all handle when we don't do so well. So, seriously, do not beat yourself up about this. You didn't do bad. You're going to make an interesting movie. Something different, right?
Yeah, I guess
it'll be
so.
Something different, and it's all about the movie, right?
Yeah, it's all about entertainment. But it does suck that all the trash talkers got their way.
I don't see them here,
I don't see them here anyway. But then again, I think the only one that was trash talking that would actually got what he was trash talking about would be Brandon. Because I think Brandon said I wouldn't make it through the waiver. And he tried. I did.
Yeah, he says that about everybody.
Yeah. So, I really want to know how far did he make it?
About 3 seconds in both times.
Really?
Yeah. He's gonna come back again. But yeah.
So he made it through.
Yeah, he made it through the waiver. But
the banner literally ate him alive.
Yeah. Like that.
That's nice, Brandon.
So you know.
That's really nice. Which I don't trash talk to you. I'm not going to, because...
Love you, Brandon.
Right now, you are beating me. You have a total accumulated time of 6 seconds in the Cake of Ender. So I'm not going to trash talk you. I have no time in the matter. I've got 2 hours in a waiver.
Keep that camera on really good. I'll be using this for my movie.
That's all I've got. 2 hours on a waiver. So I ain't going to trash talk you. Not yet.
But look, you know, how about the folks before you? What were Caleb and Amanda? They stopped at the waiver. They didn't get any further than you did. So how about
now,
that?
I want to ask, I believe she was from the Ukraine or flew 19 hours to
Christina Buster.
The one that had the heart attack that got pissed at you because you took her out.
Oh, man.
Has
she
come back?
No.
She hasn't?
No. Nope, and I won't let her come back.
You won't?
She's got some things she's got to deal with that I won't let her come. I won't let her come
so
back.
So she's physically, she's mentally unstable. She's not just me mentally.
I don't want to say, but I'm just saying she wouldn't be right for this haunt. And she wouldn't be right. I'm not saying anything about her. I'm just saying it would not be a good idea.
It would be an idiotic move on your part.
Yeah.
To allow her to come back.
It wouldn't be smart. I have to be really selective on who comes through here, and I have to choose the right candidate, right?
Yeah.
You know, some people just aren't geared for this type of show. And that's why, don't feel bad about it, dude. At least you gave it a try. And I think you can. I mean, for you, I would bring you back. So I would bring you back. You just got to let me know when you want to do
funny?
It.
Look at me right there.
You're fine.
I got no tears in my eyes.
I know, you're good now.
I'm fine. Start signing the waiver.
It's easy now. It's over now. It's easy.
Oh, God.
You got no worries now.
I wasn't really worried in the first place. The only thing that I was worried about is I can't remember what I saw it in. It was either one of the videos you posted a few months ago on YouTube, or I think it was when Holly was still here.
Okay.
The guy called, got on Facebook or whatever, I believe he was on your Facebook page, called you a sick, tormented, demented person.
Aaron Swan, we talking about him?
No, you're talking about Joe Garcia.
He's the one that you FaceTimed with, or went live with.
Oh, that was with Aaron Swan. Aaron Swan, right. Mm-hmm.
The one thing that did worry me, and I'm going to say it right now, the one thing that did worry me is when you said, it is in our contract to extract someone's tooth. That worried me. And I was going to ask you if I made it through this, if that could be opt out of the contract.
Yeah, it could, absolutely could have. Because remember, you get two items in the contract that you don't have to go with. So after you read the whole contract, there's 189 things that you're going to learn that can happen to you inside the manor. And then you have to choose two of those things that you don't want on the table. Tooth pulling.
Well, tooth pulling would definitely be one of mine. I mean, my teeth are crooked and kind of yellow.
You and me both, brother.
I try to have...
What you laughing at there, Phoenix?
I got braces. I got a $5,000 smile.
Shut up. Shut up.
Yeah, I think...
This Phoenix over there.
That would be...
Got a nice smile now.
Look at old Phoenix talking crap, right?
Hey, $5,000 smile
Is that a stain?
Ooh!
What stain where?
Yeah, it is
this
there.
One.
You're right. Oh, I like that.
Okay, I'll give you that one. That was funny. I'll give you that. That was funny.
I like that.
Those stains on my teeth. I mean,
man, he sensed about that, didn't he, though? Woo! Doggy.
But
you could have stopped that one.
That one would have definitely been out. Now, if you had, when I pulled up, said, hey, we're going to drip you down in some ice water, and if it... Today was nice. It's been nice.
Today's
all
nice,
day.
Man. Today's
it's been
good.
Amazing.
Battery's empty, Russ.
It is?
Yeah.
All right, hang on to that. Keep talking. Let me go and change batteries.
I wish.
Hey, Holly. I don't know Holly was watching.
Oh, hi, Holly.
Yeah, talk
how's
to Holly
it going?
Talk to Holly for a minute.
No, you know what? That's what I want to do. When I come back through, I will come back through.
I like to hear that.
Just because this was not a good college try, I want to come back through. And Holly, since you're in Texas right now visiting family, which is understandable, you know, Russ and Phoenix can't have all your time, you know. You got to have a life of your own, you know. When I come back through, I want to go through it with you. I want you to be here when I go back through it, Holly.
So he wants Holly here next time.
I know.
I want the whole Mckamey Manor family here when I go through.
You're really good.
I'll be honest. I do. I really do. Because it...
Holly's rough, though. I'm not going to lie to you.
Oh, she's rough.
Holly's rough. Holly's rough.
Okay.
I know.
All right.
Oh, wait. Aaron Pratt says, if Austin isn't at my tour to make me quit, I'm not going.
Oh, my God.
God.
Aaron's
all right.
Aaron's not going to be there. She thinks she's going to be there. She's not going to be there.
Oh.
There all was right. a guy from Greece, I believe. Mm-hmm. He was cheering for me. I hope he makes it.
Lots of guys. They're all cheering for you, buddy.
I believe he's coming through February 10th, I believe.
Oh, you're talking about Brian.
Yeah, Brian.
Yeah, he was watching.
Vickle or whatever his last name is. I hope you make it. I hope you get over here.
Keep that camera focused.
No problem, man. I mean, I thanks for the support. I hate that I let you down. You know, I really do. But maybe you can make it further than I did. I mentally broke myself down. I got a problem, and I'm not afraid to admit it. I have a short fuse. A short fuse. That and,
no sniffing. This is stuff that's for the movie.
Yeah, that bugs him.
In the movie. I don't want in the movie, so no sniffing. That's good. I don't care about him, you. You're silent.
Yeah, you're behind the camera.
Yeah, behind the camera. You're silent. Shut up. This is his moment. No, I think, so how do you think Brian will do on February 10th?
Realistically.
Don't just give him the rah-rah stuff. How do you think he'll do?
Realistically, I want him to make it through the waiver. I think he can. Realistically, I think he can make it. Me, I can't really give a proper estimate of how long he could make it to the manor, because the videos I've seen, like a guy I work with, he Saturday, he come to work, and he said, yeah, man, I watched some of those videos, man, they gonna get you, they gonna make you their little bee. And I was like, no, man, that ain't gonna happen. He's like, no, for real, bro, I see, they breaking people's arms. And I went, whoa, wait a minute here. Wait a minute. Run that by me again. He goes, yeah, man, they break people's arms. I was like, No, they don't. Because look at it this way. If Russ Mckamey was out there physically torturing people, in his own words, and I quote, if I was physically harming people, I would not be in business.
That's right.
I would be in jail right now.
And they're all watching for that kind of thing.
His neighbor right now, yeah, may be watching.
I know. They love watching me. And law enforcement loves watching me. They watch these live feeds. And so that's why we have to be really careful and safe and sound, which is a smart thing to do.
Yeah, which is very smart. And I completely understand why you didn't let me go through.
Yeah. But I do want you to come back.
And I will.
Okay.
I will.
So take that back about not coming back. Tell me you'll come back again.
I'll come back.
All right.
I really will. I'll come back. And I'm probably going to get the hell made, the fun made out of me. Luke Stanfield, I really hope you're watching this live feed right now. Luke Stanfield, I love you, man. If you don't know, Luke's an actor at Arx Mortis.
Yeah, he was talking a lot of trash. He was one that was talking trash.
His character's name is Akar. He is in the dungeon when he is in character. Luke, I like you, man. I really do. But there was no need for the trash talk. There really wasn't. And I'm kind of glad Tiggy tore into you the way she did. Support, man. That's all it is. So, you know what? You claimed... When you start this new job, you're getting health insurance. When you get health insurance, you're going through Mckamey Manor.
Too well do. We'll bring Luke through without health insurance. I'll figure it out. I'll work away. I'll do a waiver on him. So if Luke wants to talk so much trash, I'll bring him in next week. Next week, I have an opening on Saturday next week.
You hear that, Luke?
Invite him out.
Next week.
Next Saturday.
Russ said he'll bring you through without insurance.
Yep.
He'll make a waiver for you. You want to talk so much smack? Right here's your invitation. This right. man right here.
Luke, you were talking a lot of trash about your man here. So I'm willing to bypass the health insurance. I'll figure that out. I got ways to do that. And I'll work it out Friday, Saturday, or Sunday. Your call. So 25th, 6th, or 7th, or 8th, whatever it is, it's good to go. In fact, I'll probably even bring back Dylan as an actor for your show. How about that? That'd be good?
That would be good. I would enjoy that.
Okay. So, Luke, we got a deal, right? Next weekend, 27th, 26th, 25th, 28th, whatever. So, your job, Dylan, is to get him here. You make sure that he, all that smack talk, you get him here.
Oh, I'm friends with him on Facebook. After I leave here, I'll message him.
Okay.
And I'll relay the message to him.
And Kara, it is Kara, right? Your mom?
Carrie.
And Dalton, right?
Yeah.
I wonder if Dalton's going to go through in October.
He might.
Okay, so Carrie and Dalton, come on down. Pick up your youngster. He's ready. He's ready for a pizza. Take him out and get some food for him. And don't be too mad at me for telling him on camera that you were dogging him out, when of course you weren't. That was just part of the game I play. So it was entertaining, though. He did a good job, though, man. He did a good job. He'll make an interesting movie, right?
I hope so.
And it's all about the movie.
Because, I mean, I can't really say I like your haunted house. You know, I can't really say that I don't like your haunted house. The videos I've seen, which is all I got to rely on. Videos from California
right.
is all I got to rely on, because I don't believe you've posted any from down here in Tennessee.
No, right? Not yet.
Not yet. So, oh my God, there are some wimps out in California.
Oh yeah.
I saw one. You had these two girls in what looked like a fair ride, you know, like a roller coaster or whatever, and they're standing there, and y'all closed it, and they just lost it.
Oh, yeah.
the Ghostbuster, the blonde-headed Ghostbuster you had come through, you said, okay, here, you can sit out the rest of the tour. You don't have to do anything. Just get in the coffin. And I'm sitting there going, it's a coffin.
Yeah.
It's a coffin. There's nothing in it. He said he would leave you alone. I'm pretty sure Russ is a man of his word. He will leave you alone.
Well. I didn't with Grace. Did you watch the Haunters movie?
Yeah.
The documentary?
Yeah. Was she the one that you put in there, and then all of a sudden somebody come out of it?
She's the woman that like I tricked her to go into the haunt like three times.
Oh yeah,
she's
yeah.
She's the one that like you know said she's afraid of the coffin, and I was like, oh, it's fine. And then you know we actually did.
You put her in the coffin. She goes, don't close it on me, Russ.
Yeah,
so what did I do? I closed it.
Yeah. So you know, don't believe everything I tell you.
Yeah.
Because that's part of the game.
Yeah,
right?
It's part of the game. You're here to mentally break someone down.
Yeah.
Physically, if you get broken, it's probably because of an accident, which accidents do happen.
Can happen. Yeah.
We actually last year.
Jake West says, I will be in Maryville, Tennessee shortly. Bring it. I am ready.
Okay, well, Jake West, get your medical. Jake West, I've heard this 1,000 times too. Okay, Jake West. Get your medical letter stating that you're mentally and physically clear to participate. And I do need all that stuff from YouTube. Remember that? Okay.
I got it over there.
I need all that for the files. But Jake West, if you're ready, I'm pretty sure Luke's not going to show up next week.
I don't think Luke will show up.
So we're going to opening for you next weekend, buddy. I have an opening. Somebody bowed out. Lots of folks have bowed out for the 27th. What's wrong with the 27th? But, yeah. So all you guys think that you got it, we're here. And you know you're not going to die. We're not going to kill you. So there's no reason to quit.
Well, I don't know.
There was that one heart attack.
Yeah,
that's
true. There was that one heart attack.
That is
then,
true. That was in San Diego, though.
Yeah.
So we're not here.
You know, it's funny. Around here, we got a little running joke, especially down here deep in the South. You come up missing, you know what's going to happen. I'm going to feed you to the cops. And when the cops go, what, oh, man, what's in this? Oh, secrets in the sauce.
Oh, my gosh. You guys scare me.
So that's what's been happening, Russ, ain't it? You have been killing people, haven't you? You've just been putting them in stews.
Yeah, you know, someone's got to do it.
Yeah,
right? They're all honking for out there and stuff. That's crazy. So talk to your Arx Mortis folks, man. Because they're on your side, dude.
Yeah,
they're on your side.
I appreciate it, with the exception of Luke Stanfield. I like Luke. I really do. Luke's a pretty cool guy.
He was getting on real. He was talking some trash.
I don't think me and him, I wouldn't really classify us as friends.
Right.
They're more of acquaintances.
Yeah.
I know him. He knows me. I like him. I don't know if he likes me or not. Yeah. He's talked to me. So, Luke, man, I really didn't appreciate it. And Tiggy, I love you, girl. Oh, good Lord, she tore into Luke hard. It hurt me. That's how bad she tore into him.
She's on your side, man.
Oh, yeah.
She's got your back.
Jarvis, my section leader of the mine shaft, he was on my side. Aaron Pusser, which is a guy that has worked Arx in the past. He hasn't worked it, to my knowledge, the 4 years that I've been there. You know, of course, not everybody can be a full-time haunter. You know, 40-hour week jobs. We got other things come up.
Yeah, yeah.
Aaron, I officially met him last night. I actually went to Arx and I did a little bit of sliding for my character.
Cool. I like that.
Jethro, he's now a slider in the mine shaft and going to put some more layers to him. Aaron, man, I appreciate the support. Of course, Tiggy, Tristan. Hoocha and Tristan, I really, really appreciated the support from that. Of course, Rob Allen was there. I like Rob Allen. I don't know if you've met him or not. I can't really recall if he supported me or not, but, you know, I like to pick on Rob.
Sonny was supporting you, too. I was just saying he wasn't, but he was. Okay, so, you know. So he was.
And Sonny, Boogie, Sir Cecil, I can't really remember what name you go by anymore. I thank you, Sonny. Sonny, I just graduated high school, and Sonny ran into my mom at a Cash Saver in Loretta and said, "Hey, you know what's Dylan doing now?" "Oh, well, he just graduated. Tell him to come down to Arx Mortis.
Cool.
He might like it." So Sonny gave me and Waffles. I'm going to kind of be a little schizo here,
that's
you know.
Right.
I've got Dylan, and then I've got two other personas, Jethro and Waffles. Waffles was my first character for Arx Mortis, and Sonny gave Waffles a home in Sir Cecil's world-famous Big Top.
Nice.
And I appreciate Sonny for that. Now, granted, I left the haunted, I left the clown tent this year. I worked there two nights. I felt that I needed to expand my character a little bit more, which, you know, as you know all about that. As an actor, you know, expand. Of course, I don't know.
I started off as a boo haunt. Now look where I'm at.
the most extreme haunted house in the country.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know if you've done any acting in haunts or not, but, you know, y'all would.
Everything's an act,
yeah,
I do.
Yeah. It's like my whole life's an act. I wake up and I act like I want to get out of bed, you know?
This is an act, buddy. This is all smoke and mirrors.
Y'all can understand, you know, you got to lay depth to your character.
Yeah.
Well, actually, your character is Mckamey Manor. That is your character.
Yeah.
And
people recognize me as the manor, and the manor is me. So
yep.
That's kind of how it should be.
Oh, know? Yes. Right? Yes, that is exactly how it should be.
I've spun it a certain way, and I'll continue to do so, you know? So.
And then you got all your haters, of course.
Well, the best. The haters are the best.
The Haunters documentary. Oh, God, I love that. This one guy on there, you've watched the documentary, haven't you?
Yeah.
The one guy who had a problem with his eyes.
Oh,
with his sunglasses.
Yeah, he hates
it. I really loved his wife. His wife, like, I felt for him until he started talking trash about you. I felt for him. All he wants to do is have a homegrown haunt and do everything on October. You know, do all haunted houses are supposed to be on October. His wife did not like it whatsoever.
No.
Not one bit whatsoever. Oh, God, I felt for that man hard.
Yeah, we had a panel at Scare LA a couple years ago, and I got blind. He was on the panel, the other woman, Char, And Char and him can't stand me. And so they, you know, they think what I'm doing is just the most, you know,
evil. That legendary actor from the documentary?
Oh, yeah, she's horrible.
She worked at Blackout.
She is horrible.
Yeah,
is,
Blackout? Blackout was on that documentary, too.
Now, that's a very, very, very awful haunt. I hate it so much.
See, now, I think Blackout, from what I understood, the documentary is worse than you.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's, yeah. Here's the thing. Extreme haunt, all the extreme haunts out there, they have one, they're one trick pony, they're sexual, they're hypersexual,
yeah,
nudity, simulating rape, pulling out all these kind of crazy things, making you really put you in some bad situations.
Oh yeah,
that's what these extreme haunts are. We're not that,
no.
We're an Indiana Jones ride on steroids. We're a PG-13. There's no cussing, there's not, you know, there's nothing inappropriate.
Which is what I'm going to have to work on next time.
Oh, you know, no, that's good.
You need to work on your mouth, you know.
But I don't know of any other extreme haunt that doesn't do the sex stuff.
It honestly, it sickened me.
Yeah, it's
Blackout, it's no sickened me. They're like, yeah, we're an extreme haunt. We think Mckamey Manor is trash. Okay, what do you do? Oh, we got a guy that runs around butt naked?
Yeah.
What? You know, how are you not sitting in a courtroom right now getting a sexual harassment charge against you?
Well, they do.
I'm pretty sure, from what I understood, they would take an actual gun, walk up to their patrons, and go, okay, beg for your life. You know, why do you feel the need to put a gun to somebody's head? Russ, do you put an authentic gun to someone's head?
Nope, we don't use that kind of stuff. Because that's cheap. So, those types of activities is cheap. If you can't be more creative than pulling a gun on somebody or doing sexual stuff, then you're not very creative.
No, not at all. I believe Arx Mortis is PG-13.
Oh, you guys are great.
And I believe we're PG-13 for one reason and one reason only. Because we use blood.
Yeah, no,
that is the only reason we're PG-13.
You guys are very appropriate. Absolutely. Yeah,
I love Arx Mortis. I look forward to going back.
Well, you got a girlfriend?
I got someone I'm talking to.
Well, there you go. It's a perfect date.
February
14th, Arx Mortis, My Bloody Valentine.
Is that a weekend?
Yeah, but I'm going solo. Put this thing on me. Holly, come back and see. I know you're not back for another, like, I don't know, until the end of February now. So, Holly, come back February 14th. Come see me over at... you can't let me go there by myself. Well, I'll go by myself, though.
I believe the Valentine's Day... I believe it is on Wednesday.
Jacob David said 10th, 14th, 17th.
The 10th is a Saturday, the 14th is a Wednesday, and the 17th is a Saturday.
Which one's going to be, like, the best one?
It'd probably be either the first Saturday we're open or the last Saturday we're open. The first Saturday we're open from, it's either 6 or 7 to 11. And then that Wednesday we're open from 7 to 10. And then that last Saturday we'll be open from 7 to 11:30. And it's funny. Oh, God, it really is funny. We'll start the night out, and, you know, especially this year. Me and Jarvis would go from the break room, and, you know, by this point, I know the haunt like the back of my hand, so I'm weaving in and out of shortcuts, you know.
Right.
I get to the mine shaft, and I just peek out the emergency exit, and I went, oh, well, the parking lot ain't that full. It was only, like, 6:58, you know, almost 7 o'clock. First couple groups come through. Then I peek back out the door again, and they're lined up to dang near Brooks High School.
I love it.
Yeah, it was awesome. And then... we had one of the upper management people come through. I believe it was Mark. Come through, old Mama Mortis. I love Mama. He come through, and I went, Mark, man, are we getting out of here at 11? He goes, no, bro, we're not.
That's it. Busy, proud. I love it.
The first year I worked, it was, I think, mid-season. It was a Saturday, and Bevo. Sonny's wife comes through the clown tent, and I went, Bevo, when are we going to get out of here? She's like, it's going to be a little while. We're looking about 3 o'clock. There's still about 1,600 people in the lobby.
I love it.
And I went, what? And she goes, yeah, and we capped the line about 2 minutes ago.
Well, you guys let me know the best day to show up, and I'll be there. Okay?
Well,
I'll be there stag, but I'll be there, though.
Well, then your best two would either be the 10th or the 17th.
Okay, cool.
I believe, you know, for National Singles Awareness Day.
All right.
It's $10. $10 for a ticket, I believe. Now, don't quote me on that, because
do they accept cards or cash only?
See, that I don't know.
I bet they'll let you in, Austin.
Yeah, so Phoenix, it's all right. Man, yeah, we'll throw you in the VIP line.
There you go.
Oh well, I'll let Sonny know. I think I got him on Facebook.
So I had a couple important questions before we bail out on this thing. Did Carrie respond? Is she coming?
If she didn't, I can give her a phone call.
I know she saw it, so I don't know what.
Brandon Vance goes, Austin.
All right, so a couple questions for you. During your time here at the Manor, did anybody physically injure you in any way, shape, or form?
No, although I wanted to physically harm myself for being a whiny little baby. No. Russ Mckamey and Austin, what is your last name?
Graham.
Russ Mckamey and Austin Graham in no way, shape, or form physically harmed me.
Did I mentally mess you up in any way, shape, or form?
Mentally, he was like he was playing a game of Candyland in my head. He was having the time of his life.
That's true.
He is kind of a sick man. He really is, because he enjoys getting in your head and messing around.
But are you okay now?
Yeah, so I'm fine.
So we decompress now?
Yeah, I'm decompressed.
You know that everything I was doing was just part of this story, right?
Yeah, which... When you were doing it, I didn't. I was like, okay, everybody's trash talking me. Okay, he's playing mind games. What am I doing? I'm letting him in, and then I melted.
Yeah.
It was over. I let you in. I could not keep a strong.
Either Dalton. I'm sorry. Dalton says we are on our way. So yeah, they're on their way.
Okay. A piece of advice to anybody that comes through Mckamey Manor. Don't let this man in your head. Do not. Russ, he will get in there and he'll start poking and prodding. And then if you don't watch it, when he walks away, you'll break yourself down physically. You know what got it for me? This little camera he's holding here died. He told me to keep it on my face the whole time. I'm signing this waiver. The camera goes dead. I walked up here, not thinking, knocked on the door, handed him the camera, went back down there. He come back out and said, here's your camera back. Oh, and by the way, give me $500. And I went, what? And he goes, you're not wearing your bags. And I went, wow. Okay. Then I had a little outburst that I honestly did not mean. I'm a little ADHD, so I get a little hyper.
It's okay.
Me too.
Oh, Phoenix here, he wasn't pouring the blood on me right. He poured it all over my head, and Russ went, man, you didn't even get his face.
Nope.
I rubbed it all over my face and said, that's how you do it. Well, there went another $500. Then it pissed me off. And when it pissed me off, I started getting a little attitude with the man. And that's what you don't want to do, because me, I just said, screw it. Here's your $20,000 back. I don't need it. There's your money. You know, so piece of advice to anybody's wanting to come through. Listen to what he says. Every bit of it. Don't forget, if he walks out here and hands you a bag, don't put the bag on immediately. Immediately. You go anywhere, you got to go to the bathroom, hand him a dead camera. Keep the bag on you. Second thing is don't cuss, which I honestly did not know. I did not know that cussing was not allowed. I knew that touching the props and hitting the actors was not allowed. So I'm glad you were lenient on me the cussing. That I will know for future endeavors. Don't cuss. Do not do it. He takes $500. And now I know why nobody gets out of here with the money. It's not because it's so mentally havoc that they can't do it. It's because he nitpicks everything. Little outburst. Oh, there's $500. No bag, $500. Oh, was that the S word? $500. That's why nobody walks away with the $20,000, because he nitpicks all of it. You know, Which is very understandable. You're PG-13 hot. Yeah. You can't cuss. You've got your fan base is you've probably got 13, 14 year old kids out there, all ages watching. You can't have none of that foul language. You're already under enough pressure already with people thinking you're murdering people and physically hurting them. Last thing you need is some parent going, Russ Mckamey just cusses a lot. My kids ain't watching his stuff. They're just cussing. Foul language.
Yeah, there are some movies out there with some cussing, but I put age restriction on all those ones. But all the new stuff, though, out here, we have to be very PG-13.
PG-13.
As we always kind of have been for the most part. But so would you recommend others to take the tour?
Well, considering I didn't make it through the waiver, Russ is a pretty cool guy in Phoenix. He's a good sport. Had to talk to him. Talked with him, what, Saturday night when we talked? Or was it Friday?
One of those nights.
It was one of those nights, and I kind of felt like I hurt his feelings a little bit because
no, you're good, dude.
He was talking a little smack to Big Will, and once again, I only had half the story. Russ here put him up to it, and it kind of ticked me off. I was like, this little scrawny kid think he's gonna pick on Big Will? No, just to come out here, I recommend you just come out here and experience Russ Mckamey in his entirety. He's a cool guy. You know what he does is like what Ox Mortis does. We donate to an animal shelter, and the admission here, believe it or not, and you're going to think I'm crazy, is a 55-pound bag of dog food. And it's funny, the documentary, people were like, well, what's he charged for admission? Dog food? Oh, really? Who's eating that? No, he donates it to dogs, and they immediately went, oh, I'm a dick. You know, because... Which is weird because the little transition of Russ Mckamey, you got caring for all these dogs, and then you got, listen to me, you're gonna eat this. It looks like crap, it smells like crap, but you're gonna do it. Eat it. You know, and it's just funny. Which I told Austin when I was talking to him, I said, you know, all I know of Russ is all in the videos, you know. I just kind of feel like Russ is a happy-go-lucky guy, and then a switch flips, and he turns into a psycho. And that's what scares it. That's what scares me about him. It just, there you go. Okay, I'm crazy now. You're going to do what I tell you to.
it's fortunate that we didn't go any further today.
Yeah, and I'm disappointed that I didn't make it, but then again, safety first. Safety first.
But did you have fun?
Yeah.
Good. So was it a positive experience? Are you glad you did it? And
which I blame myself for the way my mindset was. I was prepared to come in and, as you say, eat your lunch. That's what I was coming to do. And everybody's like, no, Russ is going to eat your lunch. No, Russ ain't going to eat my lunch. My lunch is secure. He ain't coming near my lunch. I come in, I'm listening to heavy metal all week long, Slipknot, Five Finger Death, all that, and I'm just physically, and then I got ready in the wrong way. I was in the wrong mental state all week.
Did you really think that you had a chance here?
Well,
I mean, really?
Yes.
I know you got to go in.
Yes.
And feel, but you really
yes,
felt that
I
you,
really,
you felt
I figured,
that you were going to last 10
hours?
I figured
you out. I figured you out. The mayor is nothing but mind games. That is all it is. It is nothing but mind games. And I'm sitting at work and I'm talking about it. It was like, you're not going to make it. The mayor's going to eat you alive. No, they're not. It's mind games. No, man, they're going to get you. They physically cannot hurt me.
That's right. That's true.
They physically cannot walk up to me and snap my forearm in half. They can't. It's all here. Now, the pulling teeth, I did not know about. You know, now that I've said that, you pull at people's teeth, Russ, you crazy.
Well, actually, you'll pull your own tooth.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
I will give you the pliers, and that's harder. It's easier if I do it, but it's very difficult for you to pull your own tooth because your body automatically fights you to not do that.
It won't let you, just like you can't bite through your own thumb. Your brain will physically not let you do it.
Yep, it's really tough. I've only had one person able to actually pull his own tooth out.
Who?
in all these years. Now, we pulled teeth at ourselves, but I've only had one person do it themselves. They can't do it. They cannot do it. It's crazy.
Okay, so it's kind of like a video I saw. You handed this girl a taser, and I mm-hmm. didn't really hear the audio, and I'm just sitting here watching her do this with a taser. I'm just like, are you an idiot? You're tasing yourself. For what? In a haunted house? I will admit, the people you got coming through here, Russ, they're crazy.
Yeah.
They are crazy that they think they've got to submit themselves to this kind of stuff. Now, me, I can't go through a haunted house and not be scared. I love Arx Mortis to death. I really do. But 2016, I was working second shift job. And I went through it. Me and a few of my buddies went through it. And the only time I jumped, there's this door in the dungeon. It's got a 2x4 frame at the top of it, and it hinges out.
Right.
They take it, and they slam it up against that 2x4. Well, I come walking up, and I see somebody, what looks like somebody sitting in there. I got closer. I get about this far from the door. About the time she goes, whoom! I jump back and went, oh!
Yeah.
It's the only time I got scared in Arx Mortis. The whole other time, I'm like going through, I know you, you're hiding there, right, this right. isn't scary. You know, so for me to get scared at a haunted house, I need something like Mckamey Manor. I need something where they physically touch you. Now, maybe not as extreme as pulling out my own teeth or tasing
and
myself.
Your nails, you pull out your nails, too.
Really?
Yeah, you get a choice of a toenail or a fingernail. But again, you've got to pull it out.
Yeah, I mean, because once again, even if it is in your waiver, you can't do it because you're physically hurting somebody then.
That's right. So you're going to do all the things that you need to do.
Uh-huh.
And that's the beauty of it. And that's what makes it harder for you to do. You know? So, yeah, it's quite fascinating, quite interesting. And we're really glad that you participated. And I hope that you really will come back. And
I will. And if you're serious about me being an actor here. Now, I know you said for me to be an actor, to be an actor.
You actually have to go through it first.
Yeah, you actually have to go through it. I'm actually honored. And, you know, any time like this, you know, I'm assuming you're open all year round.
Every week.
So I could actually do this. I wouldn't ditch Arx, though, for Mckamey. No. Arx is my home.
Yep.
It was the first professional haunted house I worked at. And, you know, like Phoenix said, we're the number one boo haunt in the nation.
Yeah, dang right.
You know, and I enjoy Arx Mortis. But, you know, I will go through it. And whether, Brandon, if you're still watching, whether I last 0.24 seconds or the, what is it, 10 hours?
10 hours.
Or the 10 hours
Which
and go through.
Which is actually equivalent to 7 hours because 3 hours is driving. So okay. It's 7 hours of playtime.
7 hours, whether it be the 0.24 seconds you said or the 7 hours of going through both. You know, I'll come back.
Yeah, you'll come back.
I will.
You'll do it again. So you gotta get me Luke for the 27th, though, for next week. Big talking
oh.
Luke.
Oh, I'll message
him. Call him out. Shame him.
I will definitely message him and tell him what you said.
Now, one thing you owe me is you owe me an exit video. So sometime tonight, in the car or wherever, I want you to give me a nice little 5-minute exit video, just you talking on your cell phone.
Right.
Just like you did with the first time. All okay? Right. And you're good to go. Where's your mama at?
I have no idea.
Where's Dalton at?
They're probably at home. And if they're at home, they live about 45 minutes away. We live about 45 minutes away.
They were expecting you to last.
Yeah. I was expecting myself to last. Now, I got a question. Y'all are the only two here, aren't you?
Yes.
Yes.
Tonight, yeah. It all varies.
But
see, I only need one. All I need is one person to help me out.
Yeah, yeah. So it's
I auditioned and I got it.
It's not like Arx where you have 60-something actors.
No, because the stunts will speak for themselves. Because when I put you inside, like when I do the buried alive stunt, and you have to go down inside this tube, and you're inside a coffin, you're 4 feet under, and you got to figure out how to get out of it, and get hundreds of pounds of dirt flying on top of you if you do the code and the trap door. There's a variety of things you gotta do. So every stunt, and there's like 189 things to do, literally. You have to, the stunt speaks for itself. I just have to make sure you're safe. I just gotta control it. Make sure that you don't die in it. Because things are very deadly and serious if you do you know, if things go wrong. So, you know, it speaks, you know, the things I designed have all the voice.
Oh, yeah.
I can be quiet. It's just you and that, you in that situation I'm putting you in. Now you got to figure out what to do and how to get out of it. And there's fire. There's a crematorium that we're going to light you up in, and I got to get some.
Okay, that's awesome.
That's a crazy one. I got to get you all gelled up with fire retardant, and we put you in, and we tell you how to get out of it, and then you have to find your way out. And it's freaking crazy. So
how many people have you actually had get out of there?
All of them, actually. Because that one there is, now their clothes catch on fire, which is almost always, but then we put it right out.
Yeah.
But they all get out of that one. And it's pretty simple. Now, the buried alive, no one's made that one yet. The eel tank, no one's very successful with that. There's, you know, Oblivion, Spectrum, and other water ones where you have to do a lot of underwater swimming. Those are difficult. So it's tough. So that's why it's stuff that it's just, you know, it's just you and that trap that you're in. Everything's trap driven. It's crazy. So it's all in your head. Nobody's scaring you. No one's bugging you. You're just, you know. Plus you're walking around. There's animatronics. You're doing all that stuff too. But those aren't the things that are going to break you. The breakers are the difficult tasks that you have to do. And that's the kind of stuff I want you to see. I want you to see that stuff because it's crazy. You know.
And it sucks that I didn't make it that far, but next time. I will definitely be back.
Next time. Yeah, you will. You'll
and if you'll allow it, if Luke comes through next week, I will be an actor here.
Well, I'll have to think on that one, because once you're an actor, you wouldn't be able to go through it, though.
Yeah, yeah.
And I don't want to spoil it.
Which I understand, yeah, you know. I don't want none of it spoiled.
I want you to see it first. Just like Brandon wants to be an actor, but he keeps on saying no because he wants to go through it again and again and again and again and again and again. You know, so he keeps going through numerous times. So, all right, so finish it up. Talk to the fans for a minute here. Last minute words of wisdom.
No, it's not as a. It's, you know, it's funny though. I had people messaging me on Facebook. You don't want to do this. Don't do it. You really don't want to do it. I'm just going to come out and say it. I haven't seen your haunt, Russ, and I'm going to say it isn't scary. It's not scary in a sense. It's mind games. That's all it is. You come in here with a sharp mind, which I'm pretty sure I figured it out. It's mind games. That's all it is. They physically can't hurt you. You come in here with a sharp mind. Don't do like me and just... I don't even want to talk about it anymore. just come in here with a strong mind. You can do it.
All right, there you go.
He's not going to eat you.
Nope. I'm going to have me a pizza, though, pretty quick.
Yeah. He's not going to eat you.
All right, man. Well, we appreciate you stopping by and giving it your college try, and then we'll see you in February, you know, at your show. And I'll be there just strolling and watching and seeing what you guys have got going on for the February, my bloody Valentine, man. So... we appreciate it, partner. Thanks for swinging by. Go get all your stuff, like your paperwork for me. Get all that gathered up for me. All right. Say goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
All right, sports fans. Another day, another evening, another couple hours at the Manor. It's been interesting. And I guess that's it. So we'll see you in a bit. Bye. All right. Let me have that one.
Coming to give back everything the darkness stole. The light is coming to give back everything the darkness stole. The light is coming to give back everything the darkness stole. The light is coming to give back everything the darkness stole.
Hey yo, trophy wife, out you won me. Until you had to find out it's one me. Now you benched all your bum knee. Now I'm the bad guy, call me Chun-Li. Cause you was slipping.